Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. Today we have a really cool value test for you. We're going to be comparing the P252 Ryobi. This is an 18 volt brushless drill driver against the Metabo. This is the black version of the Metabo, formerly Hitachi, 18 volt drill driver. The model number for this is DS18DBFL2. These both stack up pretty well together. They both run at 1800 RPMs. This has 460 inch-pounds of torque and this has 620 inch-pounds of torque. So there is a bit of a disparity between the two, but we're gonna test them as they are today and we're gonna go through a value test. And that not only means how much power they have, but what type of results should you expect in real world situations. Thus, that's gonna be the value of the tool itself, because you can have all the power in the world, but if you can't use it when you need it, the tool isn't worth that much to you. So this test, like I said earlier, it's not only on just pure power and speed. We're gonna talk about the capabilities first. That's gonna be a category. In that category, we're gonna take a look at the types of screws that it can actually drive. So we're gonna drive an 8-inch Timberlock screw. If it can successfully drive that, you're gonna get 2 points. If it has a light on the tool, you're gonna get a point. Then we're gonna attempt to drive a 6-inch, 3/8-inch lag screw. If it can drive that, it's going to get 2 points. And then we're going to drive a 4-inch hole, and that's just with typical hole saw, through a 2-inch piece of wood. If it can do that, it gets 3 points. And then here's where it gets interesting. This is very specific for the drill drivers itself. I want to be able to go into the highest clutch setting and drive a 4-inch fastener into a piece of wood. If it can do that, it gets 1 point. Now, not only drill drivers are they specifically for high power, but they also need to be for gentle items as well, and that's what makes these ideal for woodworking. So, on the lowest clutch setting, I want to be able to drive a number 6 half-inch long wood screw without overdriving it into a piece of wood. That's going to show the flexibility and the controllability of that power. If it can do that, it's going to get 2 points. The maximum total of points at this section, you can get 11 points. Now, I do have two more sections. The next section is a ladder use section. This is where the amenities really come into play. Does it have a belt clip? Does it have bit storage? Does it have screw storage? You get 3 points for each category. The maximum number of points you can get for this particular category is 9. Now, the last category, this is torque, inch-pounds of torque per dollar. In the torque category, here's how I have it lined up. Since these aren't as powerful as other categories, we really need to be diligent in this particular section. So, if I can get 1 to 5 inch-pounds of torque per dollar, it's going to get 6 points. If I can get 6 to 9 inch-pounds per dollar, then I'm going to give it 8 points. And then if I can do 10 to 13 inch-pounds of torque, it's going to get 9 points. Now, the maximum total that anyone can get for this entire test is going to be 30 points. After every category of testing, I'm going to show you the results for that category total. At the end, we're going to tally everything up, and that's going to show you the true value. Let's go ahead and get into the first category. Bye. Let's get started. Go. Okay, there we go. Okay, so we go from the strongest this can do, now we're going to do the weakest or the most sensitive that it can do. Okay, so this drove it in halfway. Okay, so with all the power that this has, can we control it? Let's see if we can't drive this half inch screw in here and stop it before it overdrives it. This is on clutch setting 1. And I do have the speed on low, so I'm going to control this as much as possible. Oh, wow. So it stopped right before it started to hit the head of the screw itself.
So something I want to talk about, as you can see, I'm struggling a little bit. I'm on top of a ladder. I had to get the screw out of my pocket. And then once I wanted to drill something after I screwed it, I needed to remove the bit here and I had to get a drill bit. Well, I had to get this out of my pocket and I had to get the screw out of my pocket. Also, as you saw me struggle up the ladder just a little bit, that's because I'm holding the drill. When we talk about the belt clip, that allows us to suspend the drill and hang it off of our belt. That way we can safely ascend and descend down ladders, and OSHA actually states that you need 3 points of contact when you're traveling up and down ladders. So that really allows us to be a little safer. And when you're working at height, it can often be a distracting event if you're digging through your pocket. You really want onboard bit storage and you want onboard supply storage. A lot of drills do come with the belt clips. For some reason, this one didn't, so I can't give it 3 points for the belt clip. I cannot give it 3 points for the bit storage because it just doesn't have it. And I can't give it 3 points for any type of supply storage like screws. So unfortunately, this time, the Metabo doesn't get any points for this category. So in the case of the Ryobi, it's the complete polar opposite. I was able to get up the ladder with 3 points of contact because it has a belt clip here. When I got up here, I was able to pull the supplies off of the drill itself because, well, it has a mag tray right here that keeps your supplies in place. And then when I wanted to change the bit, well, it has bit storage right here. It's easy accessible, everything's in place. You can't ask for anything better. This provides you the maximum safest working and most convenient working conditions when you're on a ladder. That means this gets 9 points total. 3 points for the bit storage, 3 points for the mag tray, and 3 points for the belt clip. So let's go ahead and take a review of this particular category.
All right, so let's go ahead and talk about the last category, and that's inch pounds per dollar. So what I do is I price these out, and I don't price them out on sale. I do the full retail value. So you can get this particular drill driver here, and this is the Metabo. You can get it from Lowe's, and this is going to cost you $150. That's with a charger and with a battery itself. Now with the Ryobi, they actually don't sell this at Home Depot anymore, but you can go on Amazon and you can find this drill driver with a battery, and that's going to cost you $150 as well. So how this particular section works is that we need to take the total inch pounds of torque and we divide that by the cost. Now, what that's going to equal out to be is how many inch pounds of torque per dollar. And we have that categorized. So for the Ryobi itself, if we divide that down, that's right around 3 inch pounds of torque per dollar. That's going to put it in the first category of 1 to 5. You're going to get 6 points for that. Now for the Metabo, that's 620 inch pounds of torque that it has, and it's also $150. So that's really going to come out to be right around 4.13 inch pounds of torque per dollar. That's actually going to put it in the same range, so they both get 6 points for that particular category. Now let's go ahead and talk about the full total, and this is where it gets interesting, everyone. The Metabo has the power, more power than the actual Ryobi itself. Has 620 inch pounds of torque, where this only has 460 inch pounds of torque. So the Ryobi did come out on top this time, and the Metabo didn't. And that's the very interesting thing about the value test, because it's not going to show you just the power, but a full rounding and how you're going to use these tools. So anyways, everyone, I hope that this test provided some good information, some good direction to you. If it did, please hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe. We're going to see you in the next video.